चेक चेक हेलो चेक चेक हेलो
Good evening to all, and we apologize for the technical issue. I welcome you all to today's NVIS webinar. Today's topic is Know Your Butterflies, Journey Through the World of Wandering Wings by Chaturved Sheth. He has delivered several talks on various aspects of butterflies to schools, colleges, and general public, and also has co-authored several book chapters related to butterflies, as well as published papers in conferences, and has created several butterfly gardens at various institutions, and has actively taken part as a resource person in several schools, colleges, and corporate events for orientation programs. So I welcome you. Welcome Chaturved Sheth for today's webinar. Over to you, Chaturved.
Good evening, teachers and students. Thank you, Dipti, for your wonderful introduction. Today here we are, you know, here to discuss about wandering wings, that is beautiful butterflies. Why are they, how, you know, important they are, what is the ecological role, and why to observe, why to conserve. So these many aspects I'll be covering in my talk. Before introducing butterflies, you know, I just want to give you an overview of butterflies. All butterflies insects, but not all insects are butterflies. So the word insect is derived from the Latin word, which is insectum, which means cut into section. All insects will have, you know, three body segments, that is head, thorax, and abdomen, and also three pairs of jointed legs, that is six legs. And if those insects which are flying, they'll be having two pair of wings and one pair of compound eyes. This makes an insect an insect. Potentially over 90% of the, you know, animal life on the earth are covered by insects. We have 50 lakh plus species, you know, described species of insects, and insects are the most diverse group of animals. Insects are the only invertebrates that are able to fly. And interesting fact of butterfly is that they taste their, you know, food by their feet. All the taste buds, you know, are in its leg. That is how they taste their food. Butterflies and moths are the only insects to have scales on their wings. As I said, butterflies and moths have scales on their wings. That is why, you know, they are belong to order Lepidoptera. In Greek, lepis means scales, pteron means wings. And these are the only insects to have scales on their wings. Both moths and butterflies equally colorful. It's just that, you know, we don't observe moths because they are nocturnal. But there are also, you know, few day flying butterflies and moths also. So how to differentiate? The first and foremost, their differentiation is because of the antennae. Order Lepidoptera is again divided into two suborders, Heterocera, which means varied antennae, that is moths, and Rafflocera. Rafflo means club, cera means antennae, that is butterflies. And if you see in this diagram, you can see on the top row, all the moths have, you know, varied antennae, whereas we cannot see them antennae very prominently. On this left, the antennae is backwards, on this right, which has, you know, antennae on sidewise. But if you see butterflies in this bottom row, all the antennas are straight towards and they are pointed upwards. Next, if you have a close look up, you know, you can see moth's antenna feathery. You can see on the right side where, you know, two different moths antennae. It might be, you know, feathery two sides or one side. Whereas in butterflies, it is bulged or clubbed at the tip. And in a resting position, different moths can form this plane shape or jet shape form, which butterflies can't. Either they spread their wings sideways, if not close upwards. And this is also, again, you know, different moths, fruit piercing moths, which has an irregular shape, which butterflies cannot. These minute characteristics, if you start observe, you can differentiate moths and butterflies very easily. And let us know few, you know, famous and notable moths and butterflies. What are these Lepidoptera? White-witch moth, which is known as the longest wingspan, and it has the longest wingspan. It is close to 30 inches. Next, world's largest moth is an Atlas moth. And this is India's second largest moth. We call it as moon moth. In Bangalore also you can see, even in Karnataka, various parts you can see this beautiful moon moth. Now, coming to butterflies, world's largest butterfly is Queen Alexandra birdwing, which is restricted to few parts of New Guinea. And India's largest butterfly is Southern birdwing. And this is endemic to Western Ghats and of South India region. And the smallest butterfly is African grass jewel and Oriental grass jewel. These two grass jewel varieties can be seen in, various parts of Karnataka. Even you can see document in Bangalore region also. All these two photos, I've clicked myself in Lalbagh and Madiwala Lake. Observing butterflies. The moment you start observing, you might be thinking, oh, observing butterflies is a little difficult. How will I, identify, document? It's very simple, children. Observing doesn't mean catching. All what you have to do is, one should have keen eyes to observe small things in nature. The moment you start observing, you'll be, carried by the fascinating world of butterflies and moths. All you have to do is just observe. No matter you have two eyes or four eyes, you should have keen eyes to observe small things in nature. Once you start observing, you can, see beautiful life stages and entire life cycle of butterflies. Butterflies and moths undergo complete metamorphosis, that is complete life cycle, which has four different stages, starting with egg, caterpillar, third is pupa or chrysalis, fourth is adult stage. Four different stages of butterfly life cycle look very differently in four different stages. They consume, different time for complete metamorphosis, transformation and changes. First and foremost duty of caterpillar is to eat nicely. That is how it can grow, because caterpillar is the only growing stage in a butterfly life cycle. So it has to eat nicely, eat heavily, then it starts, pupating. Once it is fully fed, it can shed its skin. This happens 5 to 10 minutes life stage. So caterpillar having the longest lifespan in butterfly life cycle. You can see a small, caterpillar just emerging out of eggshell. It will be, the eggshell will be the first food meal for caterpillar for two major reasons. First is eggshell as protein, it gets energy. Second, to just erase the trace that it has emerged out, so that it will not leave any trace to its predators. After eating heavily, finds a safe place, then, it starts pupating. We have landed on Earth, Moon, Mars, but we have not landed inside this pupa. No one knows what happens inside this pupa. From outside, I can just say it is a great chemical reaction, physical reaction, biological reaction, history, mystery, magic is happening. But trust me, children, the sighting of, butterfly emerging out from its pupa is a beautiful sighting, which is very rare and difficult also. Out of my 8 years of experience, only twice I have seen, a butterfly emerging out from its pupa. As I said, pupa is the third stage. Complete development happens in this stage. So third stage is pupal stage, which we call it as a dormant stage or development stage. A caterpillar just converts into a pupa, and inside we don't know what happens. Then the adult butterfly just emerges out from its pupa, then starts its behavior. We can also observe various behaviors. First and foremost is feeding. Butterflies have a special organ called proboscis, which can feed strictly on liquid diet. It cannot eat or chew. That is why butterflies and moths are also very sensible and beautiful creatures. They can't bite you or sting you. That makes very unique compared to other insects. If you see on this, it is not only butterflies feed on nectar. Also, it has very, various food source. First, butterflies are attracted to socks also. That means for sweat, because it gets all the salt particles. Next, on the third slide, you can see here, a skipper which is feeding on bird dropping. From these bird droppings and animal dungs also, it can extract few minerals. And the fourth here, you can see a black common hormone butterfly, just observing, minerals and salts from the wet sand. Here, if you see, these two butterflies are, just feeding on a tree sap. It is like a few plants produce latex, milky latex, and these are, feeding on it. And next behavior is basking. All insects are cold-blooded, hence they want sun rays, you know, to generate their body temperature. You can see butterflies and insects all over the world except in Arctic and Antarctic region where there are no insects, no reptiles. Then recent days you would have started observing these blue color beautiful butterflies which are, you know, flying in huge number. That we call it as, you know, local movement. These blue tigers, dark blue tigers, common crows, these are the butterflies which migrates from, you know, Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats. On the way, they stop to Bangalore, say hi to Bangalore kids, and they start moving towards Eastern Ghats. Now also you can see few blue tiger butterflies flying in good number. Just start observing. If you can see this, you can document. All these are, you know, blue tigers and common crows, dark blue tigers. Next, mud puddling. You all know, you know, various animals in animal kingdom, males have to struggle very hard to impress female. Same wise here also, all these yellow butterflies and few swallowtails are collecting salts, which is like a dowry to female. These males have to give, carry salts and give it to females. That is when female will select her and he will be passed. And not all insects can migrate. Only one of the, you know, dragonfly, which is called as common, you know, globe skimmer or wandering glider, is known for migration. And apart from that, even butterfly is also known for migration. The very famous butterfly, which we call it as monarch butterflies, are, you know, very famous for migration. These monarch, you know, migrates, northern and central United States monarchs migrates to Florida and Mexico. And the western North American monarchs migrates to South California. That is approximately 4,000 miles. You just imagine these beautiful small butterflies having very less lifespan. They are migrating, they are traveling 4,000 miles. During this period, all the Florida, Mexican people get, you know, vacation. Just because of, you know, butterfly migration, people over there get vacation. Threats to lives. What are the, you know, threats? 70% of birds are insectivore, which feeds mainly on these caterpillars. And there are also a few parasitic wasps, which, you know, lay eggs on these caterpillars. Here on the right side, you can see two different, you know, caterpillars. Above one is, you know, hawkmoth caterpillar, and below is a lime swallowtail caterpillar. You can see it is infected by a parasitic wasps. And next, spiders. In India, 99% of spiders are insectivore. Only few spiders which are larger in size can feed on other bigger organisms like small birds and lizards. And even in plants also attract, we think, you know, plants attract only to pollinate, but, you know, this insectivore plant is feeding on a grass jewel butterfly. See, butterflies not only feed various reptiles, birds, lizards, spiders, also plants. So these are also a good food source for insectivorous plants. Next, I said butterflies cannot, you know, sting or bite. So how will they escape? These are the few common steps which they have adopted during their co-evolution to escape threats. First and foremost of caterpillar camouflage. You can see three different caterpillars on leaf, which exactly has a leaf pattern. That is how, you know, they escape. First one here you can see. Second one, this is, you know, common barren caterpillar, which is on mango leaf. This is a caterpillar. It has, you know, hairs also, spiny hairs, but the leaf margin and caterpillar margin is very resemblance. For smaller brains like birds, lizards, it can easily fool. We can find out very easily where the caterpillar, but for smaller organisms with smaller brain, it can fool it very easily. Here, third caterpillar, which is on the castor leaf. This castor leaf, same pattern is also again adopted by these caterpillars. Fourth is, you know, it is a pupal stage of a common mime, which just looks like a small twig piece, which can again confuse other bigger organisms. And here, this is, you know, beautiful butterfly. We call it as, you know, oak leaf butterfly. If it is on ground, it is very difficult to find. It will be always on thick foliage and in dense forest. Because this brown leaf shaped butterfly is on green leaf, we can make out very easily. And the last is my favorite butterfly. We call it as glad eye bush brown. It has an eye mark. So none of the insects or lizards dare to go near because the eye pattern is similar to our human eyes. And small butterflies have a special relationship with ants. We call it a symbiotic relationship, where these small caterpillars on its 13th segment, they have special gland which can secrete a honeydew, a sugary syrup. These ants go and poke them, and this caterpillar releases that sweet sugary syrup. So caterpillar get protection and ants get its sweet sugary syrup. This kind of, you know, symbiotic relationship you can observe in and around your area, which butterfly caterpillar is in which ant colony, and what is the symbiotic relationship, or how long it has been carrying or observing. You can see, document. Very less papers and works have been carried out. We all can tell easily that, you know, caterpillars have a symbiotic relationship with ants. No one knows which specific caterpillar has a special adaptation with, adjustment with ants. Students, you can start observing day one, and very less activities and researches have been carried on this topic. You can select one ant colony. If you can see any caterpillars nearby, you can start observing. This is a best, you know, project which students can sit at their home and just start observing. Next, field notes. Just looking at wing pattern of butterflies and how they fly, what level they fly, it is very easy to document and name. In Bangalore, in Karnataka, majority of the butterfly names are because of the wing, color, size, and how to, what level they fly. First and foremost, you should observe wing pattern, that is spots or dots or stripes. Different butterflies have, you know, different patterns. That is why the name. Example, striped tiger, a medium size orange butterfly with black stripes. We call it as plain tiger or striped tiger. And you can also see flight level, whether it is flying close to grass level or ground level, tree level or very high. Next, you can just compare a size of a butterfly with your fingernail. Small, medium or large. Trust me, children, and you can see butterflies will never grow. A completely developed butterfly is coming out from its pupa. So if you see a small yellow butterfly and a big yellow butterfly, they are two different species. So it is very easy to document, and you can also note it is a different species. Observing this size, you can also categorize six different families are there, and all six families are documented from Bangalore region. First and foremost, all big butterflies or large butterflies, you can, you know, just call them a swallowtail. The name swallowtail means because of the extra projection on its lower wings. You can see a small tail-like structures. Not all swallowtails have this tail structure, but only few are there. And all large butterflies, big in size, with various black and red, green, or you can, you know, call it them as swallowtail, a big butterflies. Next, whites and yellows. All butterflies which are in yellow in color, they belongs to yellow family. Which are in whites with different shades, they belong to white family. Larger the size, swallowtail. Small size, medium size, with yellow and white color, second family. Third, all small ones you can categorize into blues. Majority of these butterflies, when they open their wings, they have the, you know, shades of blues, violet, silverish, bluish, purple, violet. And all small butterflies come under this third category, which are blues. The interesting feature of these blues, they have, you know, extra tails and, you know, small crown spot, which resembles like a head. So these small blue butterflies can escape its predators very easily, because it is like, you can see here, the crown spots here, you know, resembles a head, and, you know, it can easily fool other organisms. In this second, if you can see here, it's a antenna and head. Same way here, there's a small crown spot and also tail. So that is how, you know, they fool other organisms. These are very small, and the world's smallest and India's smallest butterfly belongs to this category, grass jewel. And next is skippers. The name skipper suggests they have hopping flight or jumping flight. In skippers, there are two varieties. One variety is they just spread their wings, which we call them as flat. Here you can see spotted small flat. Size is small. It has spots, so hence it is called a spotted flat. Next, you can see grizzled skipper. Grizzled because of the checkered pattern. It is because of the various white spots it has. See, it is flat. Whereas if you see other four skippers, it has, you know, closed its wings. Again, it has like a plane shape or A shape or jet shape. this kind of, you know, small butterflies with various flight and wing pattern, you all can call them as skippers. And the interesting, you know, majority of them have black eyes, and this one skipper has, you know, very red, brilliant colored eye. Next is Ryanidae, that is Judis. In entire South India and Western Ghats, we have only two species of Judis, and only one species is seen from Bangalore, which is double-banded Judy. The speciality of this butterfly is it cannot fold its wings completely. Like other butterflies can touch both the wings, the wing is not touched here. You can see there's a gap when it is closing. So this is a separate family. And the last out of all the five families, whichever comes in small size, medium size, which are not in white color, yellow color or blue color, which are medium size, you can call them as brush footed because of the, you know, their front lug is modified into brush like, hence they are called as brush footed. This is the, you know, largest family which has the highest number of species, and this is very globally distributed. In this you can see they are, you know, different orangish in color with spots. An animal which has spots is famous as leopard. We have called this butterflies common leopard, which is very common, and also it has black spots like leopards, common leopard. You can compare its size, spots or dots, it is very easy to remember. Second one, orange color, it has, you know, coaster ride flight. Its flight pattern is little different, so it's like tawny coaster. Tawny means orange color, and coaster, coaster ride. Its flying pattern is different. And if you see this third butterfly, lemon pansy, it has eye-like markings. Not only moths can have eye-like markings, even butterflies have these small eye-like markings. These again warns, indicates, and, you know, helps to escape from its predators. When it's closed, you can see a ring patterns. If this ring varies, a species varies. Or all what you have to do is just count the number of rings and you can name it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Only the small four rings are considered, hence it is called as common four ring. This big ring is not considered. And next is common baron. Baron means, you know, different stages, positions like commander, baron, and this indicates they chase other butterflies, so hence they are called as common baron. And this, you know, lay eggs on mango tree. And next is tailed palm fly. Because it has extra projection like tail, it is called as tailed palm fly. Different butterflies come in different size, season, patterns. All what you have to do is observe, start documenting. And diversification. In globe, we have more than 18,000 butterflies. In Indian region, it is 1,504. Still a great research is happening. Every day we are finding new subspecies, species. In Western Ghats is home to more than 346 butterflies, out of which 40 butterfly plus are endemic to Western Ghats only, which means they are not seen outside the world. They are seen only in Western Ghats. Karnataka has, you know, close to 316 butterflies. In Bangalore, 153 species. This is my count. From today onwards, in your area, you will start documenting and you will give us what is the count documented from your area. So hence it is big question mark. Start observing, then you can publish. What are the materials required for documenting? How to document? First and foremost, field guides and manuals are there. All, you know, e-books are there, e-guides are there, and field manuals are there. You can start referring it. Next, collecting dead ones. Please do not, you know, catch or kill any live butterflies. If you find any dead ones or wings, you can collect it. Looking at the wing pattern, stripes or spots, we can name it. Majority of the universities in India have banned collection of specimen. Earlier, you know, entomologists used to catch live specimens for the purpose of documenting. Now there's a control, and most of the universities have told not to collect any live specimens. Hence, I request all of you not to collect a live specimen. Just pick up if it is dead. Next, camera. We are in digital world. Artificial intelligences in boom. All what you have to do is just search for lives while you do research. All can become researchers. Searching is not enough. You have to just do researching. Use your, you know, cameras, smartphones, technology to learn ecology. Start clicking butterfly photos. Documentation format. First and foremost, date is very important. Sorry. Next is time, location, weather condition. And all these parameters are equally important to do any biodiversity documentation or research, because not all butterflies are seen throughout the year. As I said, they have very less lifespan. So it can live only for 2 months or 3 months. So date, time matters, and location, from which location are you started documenting butterflies also matters. In Bangalore, I have just documented from majorly 6 places like, you know, Lal Bagh IIC campus, GKVK campus, Madiwala Lake. But from your area, again, you can start documenting, you can collect data. And weather condition, whether it is cloudy, sunny or rainy, you can also document. So based on these parameters, we can check from which area you have collected and what is the data, what is the species list. And how to document: common name, family, as I said, 6 major families, and you can just categorize based on its colors, wing pattern, flying shape, individual count. If you want to do a population count, if you are seeing a same butterfly like 3 or 4, you can also note down individual count. And next, activity: was it feeding or basking or mating? What was it doing? You can, you know, account, checklist and document different activities of butterflies. Last is characteristics. As I said, you can just jot it down whatever is important, whatever you see. For me, a green butterfly might be dark green or light green. For you, it might be sea green. You just observe, document whether you should, you know, mention whether tails are seen or not, which, you know, upper wing had brown and lower wing had greenish color, orangish color, eye-like markings, or it was flying close to ground. All this, whatever you observe in field, you can document here and you can note it down. Why it is important, why we have to observe, why we have to conserve? It is said majority of the food, that is close to 70% of food what we eat, are pollinated by insects. And butterflies and moths are also a major contribution for pollination. Hence, butterflies and moths are studied as pollinators. Next, indicators. Insects are studied as indicators. If you see good number of mosquitoes, we can conclude there's a stagnant water body, there's a pollution. Similarly, if you see good number of butterflies and moths, we can, you know, tell that, you know, there are good number of flowering plants and a host plant. Next, food chain and food web. As I said already, I've showed in previous slides, majority of the spiders and insectivore birds feed on caterpillars and butterflies, which butterflies and moths have a major role in the food chain and food web. And the fourth one is very interesting: butterfly host plant interaction. Not all your plants can attract butterflies and moths to lay eggs. Specific plants by moths and butterflies are chosen to lay eggs. Such selected plants, we call them as larval host plant. And trust me, you can experiment this small experiment. You plant aloe vera, you plant tulsi, and you plant lime plant, and butterfly knows which is its host plant. You cannot fool a butterfly, but butterfly can fool you. And various technologies also have been copied, mimicked, looking at butterfly scales. Our solar panel is designed, aligned, and, you know, refined looking after butterfly scales. And various display technologies, what we are using is after looking at, you know, various butterfly scales. Great research is still happening looking at the butterfly scales. And this is how a butterfly scale looks in a very close up view. And scientists also tell that because butterflies have scales, and that is like powdery structure, studying that, they have, you know, found out biosolvent or eco-friendly paints and chemical products. How, see, valuable they are ecologically and technologically. What do we do, or how we do? Don't chase butterflies. Just mend your garden, let the butterflies come. How we can and what we can? These are the various butterfly parks in our country, and we can also design, develop and create our own butterfly garden. First and foremost step is just you plant host plants. This is, you know, one live example, which is Sammilan Shetty's butterfly park in Belvai Moodbidri region. And this is India's first private butterfly park. He has converted his entire private land and made it as a butterfly garden. Next, we have a similar butterfly garden in Alwas, Alwas College campus, that is in Mijar Moodbidri. all what you have to do is just plant these common host plants. As I said, they are, you know, very specific to their host plants. These are then very commonly available, which are like creepers, herbs, shrubs, and trees. You select which plants or trees you can start planting and observing in and around your school campus or house or terrace. Once you start planting all these host plants, this is the proof that, you know, you have attracted a butterfly. This is on my, you know, friend's place, which is in third floor. She has just planted a curry leaf plant, and you can see the proof. You can see egg, a small caterpillar, and then it started eating. Once it starts eating, see, that is how it has grown. As I said, caterpillar is only growing stage. You can see different stages of caterpillar. All this you can just sit, observe in your free time or in during this lockdown period, because you may not be able to go out. Once it is grown, that is how a complete grown swallowtail caterpillar looks like. And this caterpillar has a snake-like marking. Again, it is to show off that I am very beautiful, bright, brilliant color. I have a snake-like marking. I am a snake. Don't come and eat me. That is how, you know, they have evolved these patterns to escape its predation. Trust me, it is very interesting to see different caterpillars, you know, look in different colors, sizes, patterns. And all these are, if you just plant host plant, you can see and you can invite all these guests. Butterflies are the best botanist. After observing butterflies, I have started learning, you know, botany also. No one knows how a lime butterfly can always search for a lime plant and lay eggs. If you plant aloe vera, it will not come and eat. Butterflies have understood that aloe vera plant is lady's product. Next, you plant a tulsi plant next to your any of these host plant, it will not come and feed. Butterflies know that tulsi has been used by mother, so it is mom's product. They don't destroy. Only its larval host plant, they feed, they eat, they defecate. Again, it is a good, you know, fertilizer for your plants. Natural fertilization, you can see it. Once you start planting, you will, you know, attract good number of butterflies. Please, you know, do not kill caterpillars and complain there are no butterflies. The moment you plant host plants, and if that butterfly is very nearby, it will come search and, you know, lay eggs. You should not get panic once you see a caterpillar. Instead, you should be very happy and start documenting its life stages. And avoid pesticides or insecticides. The whole point is to attract butterflies, and that is why we are planting host plants. And there is no point if you use, you know, pesticides or insecticides in your garden. Encourage planting host plants. As I said, not all plants are selected by butterflies and moths to lay eggs. Specific plants are called as host plants, and do plant and plant more in number of all those host plants. Any doubts, you can always, you know, reach. This is my Gmail ID. chaturvedshet@gmail.com. And this is my contact number. As I said, now we have one option where, you know, we can click photos and send it. You can always WhatsApp to me whenever I can see that image, and I will just identify for you and use technology to learn ecology. Okay, any questions? I will be happy to answer now. So many. Okay. Fine. Students, teachers, any question, please do post. Okay, already I have a question. Fine. Kavya Shri is asking, does all the tailed butterfly belongs to swallowtail family? Not necessarily. All large butterflies come under swallowtail family. Even small blues have tails which do not come under swallowtails. So only larger butterflies with or without tail belongs to swallowtail family. Hope I have answered your question. Any other questions? You are always free to post. You are welcome. Okay, Bhumika has one question. She is asking, in which weather condition more butterflies are found? As I said, butterflies are seen throughout the year and different species are active in different time intervals. Hence, different season will be noted to observe specific butterflies. For me, monsoon season is the best season because more number of plants are flowering and you can see good number of butterflies during monsoon. Okay, Mr. Karthik has one more question. During migration of tiger species butterfly, how many generation it takes to reach Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats? As I said, it is only one generation. Once it is grown, they don't have, you know, second life chance. Within the first generation, the moment they start growing in the Western Ghats, they start migrating to Eastern Ghats. Before completing the life cycle, they have to reach their destination. Hope I have answered your question. Thank you, Karthik.
Now you ask question to scientists. If you can make what who all are there.
Okay.
You should be able to find out who all are there. Huh? Randomly.
Deepa is asking, any reference books for kids and adults? There are only few books on butterflies for Indian region. One is by, you know, Isaac Himkar, Book of Indian Butterflies. Second one is by, you know, Milind Bakare and Hemant Ogale, which is Butterflies of Western Ghats. Similarly, I am also developing one butterfly ebook for all the kids, which is very friendly, colorfully designed and with easy text. Very soon I'll be sharing this material and it will be access to all the schools and students. Okay, Nisha is asking, sir, how can we preserve dead ones at home? Dead butterfly wings are like organic and they attract few ants or other insects. All what you have to do, just press it in a paper or a plastic sheet and keep it in your book safely, and you can preserve it for like close to 2 to 3 years. Over the time, all this, you know, scales will start shedding and the wing color is like transparent. So once you start noting, and if you are familiar and thorough with the wing pattern, if you can identify butterflies, you can just, you know, collect it. As long as it is safe with you, you can preserve it. All what you have to do is just press it and keep it and safely with some paper or plastic materials. And as I said, plant more number of host plants and attract and start observing all these live butterflies. In next slide, I have something. Butterflies attract trees or plants the most. As I said, host plants are different. They are like some are like herbs, shrubs, creepers, climbers, trees, plants. Different butterflies have different, you know, host plants. They range from creeper to a tree. Whatever you can plant it in your garden or terrace. If you have a small place, you can, you know, plant small varieties. If you have a good space in your garden or in your school campus, you can grow for trees. That is what, you know, list I shared. These are, you know, few herbs, shrubs, trees varieties, and also grass variety which you can plant. Majority of the butterflies are toxic, poisonous, but they cannot harm us or kill. There are few, you know, milkweed butterflies which feed on different Calatropis and other Aristolochia varieties, but they cannot kill us or harm us. Okay, Vinita has a beautiful question. Sir, her question is, do butterfly have symbiotic relationship with any other insects or animals? as I said, very less studies been carried out with respect to this topic. So far, we have found out only butterflies have a symbiotic relationship with ants, and I don't know, or still I am also searching on this aspect, whether do butterflies have any other symbiotic relationship with other insects or a bird.
Okay, Archana is asking, is there any catalog?
Mrs. Archana is asking, is there any catalog to identify different species? Yes, different, agricultural universities and other colleges do have catalog, and they have specimen collected also, which you can again refer. Even in GKVK campus, we have, which is close to Airport Road, on the way you can see. In GKVK campus, you have a separate section for butterfly studies, and you can observe there. Vinay is asking, is all big butterflies belong to swallowtail? Not necessarily all big butterflies belongs to swallowtail. In Bangalore, which I mentioned, majority of the large butterflies are swallowtails. We have only medium sized nymphalids, whereas there are other nymphalids, that is brush footed, which are larger in size. Say for example, Malabar tree nymph, or cruiser or red spot duke. These butterflies are larger in size. They belong to brush footed, not necessarily a swallowtail. A very commonly asked question, again Venugopal is asking, how many days the butterfly can live? I cannot cage a butterfly, so no one knows what is the exact number of days a butterfly can live. It is just our hypothesis and our approximation. Smaller the life, smaller the size, it has lesser the lifespan. Larger the butterfly, it has longer lifespan. Butterfly, life stages varies from 2 weeks to 7 months. Okay, Sagar is asking, when can we take, pick off butterflies? Early in the morning, just 20 to 30 minutes before sunrise, majority of the butterflies will be inactive. You can go click, or immediately after sunrise, majority of the butterflies will be active, and they'll start carrying out its activities. It will start basking and flying. During this time you can click butterflies. If not, after like dark, that is dawn and dusk, evening after 4:35, when all the butterflies started to roost under the leaf or hide, you can go click pictures. Okay, Anthony is asking, sir, butterfly wings are made up of which type of materials? All those are scales, and the scales has same protein like what we have in nails, but our nails are not colorful as butterfly scales. Because of the structural alignment and arrangement, butterflies are very colorful, and also the pigment which is already present in butterflies make them very colorful. They are the same nano scales which has proteins. Okay, Vinita is again asking, sir, why butterflies have powder on its wings? They are not powders, they are nanoscales. As I told, if you start catching butterflies, you would have seen, a colory powdery structure. All those are nanoscales. That is why I always tell not to catch or harm butterflies. They are very sensitive, delicate, and if you broke their wings, it is very difficult. They cannot survive. Without the wings, they cannot fly. If they are not able to fly, they are easily eaten by other organisms. Hence, please do not catch or try to catch butterflies. All what you have to do is shoot with your cameras, observe with your eyes. Okay, one more question is from Vinita again. Which season swallowtail butterflies are mostly seen? As I said, throughout the year you can see different swallowtails, and you can start documenting. Very good question again from Meghana. Sir, how can we avoid repeated count? There is always one method. When I'm walking in a transect, we always tend to count a butterflies which is flying on our right. We do not turn back and take the same count. Again, there will be some bias if the butterfly is flying in and around. So always we keep plus 0.5 or minus 0.5 variation. It varies. You should be very authentic and very keen in observing and while counting number of species. Okay, from Yashaswini, there is a question. How many days it will take to grow and come out of pupa? Different species of pupas consume different amount of time. Maybe it is like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks. Some butterflies, they'll be like completely dormant. It takes 3 to 4 months. During winter, it will be like numb. There's no outer or inner development in the pupa. And now in this season, you can see a long duration. These affects climatic conditions. These are affected by climatic conditions. So it is on an average 2 weeks to 3 months. That is how the pupal stage takes place. Any more questions? At last, I have one doubt. What happens if we don't conserve butterflies? This is what happens. I always tell, we should show and gift Mother Earth to our next generation. If you don't observe or conserve, this is how we'll have to show to our next generation. Hope will not reach this stage where we'll have to show butterfly painting or like fancy dress or in a sari design. Please do observe, conserve, then start documenting butterflies. Butterflies have four different stages. Four different stages give us a small message to students. Not only to students, all. First stage is egg stage. As always, TVR sir says, we should be responsible, sensible and sensitive. Be sensitive like egg. Second stage is caterpillar. Eat nicely like a caterpillar. Caterpillar is only growing stage. That is why it will eat nicely. If you eat nicely, you can think wisely, work properly. So eat nicely and have more green food, energy food, which will increase your immunity, stamina and brain capacity. Third stage is pupal stage. No one knows what happens. That is how a student should work, study quietly, silently like a pupa. Let your work speak. You study, your result will show what you have studied. So work like a pupa. Last stage is adult stage. How butterflies are very colorful, even you should be colorful. If you eat nicely, work properly, your life will be as colorful as butterflies. Keep observing butterflies. Thank you so much. Few more questions. Okay, Vina is asking, white and yellow butterflies belongs to which family? That is a special and separate family which we call it as whites and yellows. All white and yellow butterflies will belong to whites and yellows, that is Pieridae. Okay, Meghanath has asked a beautiful question. During migration, does butterflies overcome the extreme climatic conditions? Not all butterflies can migrate. Only a few butterflies have evolved to migrate. During this, yes, maybe or may not be, they can come under different climatic zones. And there are not extreme climatic conditions. In India, it is always during the ambient temperature, that is when they start migrating. Okay, Vinita is asking, how can we identify male and female butterflies? Very easily you can identify male and female only in few species, whereas in majority of the butterflies it is very similar. It is very difficult unless until you dissect and see its organ. In few butterflies I can tell females are larger in size and less colored, whereas males are brightly colored and smaller in size. And in few butterflies, females mimic other butterflies. So that is how we can differentiate male or a female and butterflies. And very strictly, and it is very difficult to identify or tell for all the species. Commonly, whatever we see, we can differentiate male and a female. Okay, Shankar is asking a beautiful question. Sir, what makes beautiful unique? I will have to summarize. Butterflies and moths are the only insects to have scales on their wings. That is why they are very special. Next, they cannot bite or sting like other insects. They are very delicate. Next, butterflies are always fascinated human imagination, creativity, technology, ecologically. So that is why butterflies are very unique. Bhumika is asking, you know, how can we preserve our dead or collected butterflies if it is powdery? It is too delicate, sensitive. All what you have to do is just lift it from a paper or a leaf, see, photograph, then you can leave it. Because we are in the era of, you know, artificial intelligence. You can use it, and if you are not able to collect it or preserve it, no issues. You can just draw, sketch, paint, or photograph. Okay, last question is from Meghana. Is there any maximum distance for migration? What we have studied, one is Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats, and there are other few butterflies which are migrating in Himalayan region. There are no great distance migration as we observe in Florida, Mexico, and Canada. We don't have such long migrations. In India, it is only small distance migration. Thank you so much. Thanks for your patience. Any doubts, anytime you can please, you know, reach out. I'm very thankful to, you know, TV Ramachandra sir for giving me this opportunity and for all his support. And I'm also very thankful to Deepthi and Sator, who is instrumental in having this live stream video. And also I'm thankful to all my office mates, my seniors, organizations, and all my friends, students. Whatever we do, it is for students. All students have to start observing butterflies, conserving. Your observation can lead to a conservation. I wish you all the best. Thank you so much. Next.
Thank you, Chaturved, for a very taking us through the beautiful world of butterflies, and thank you for all for participating in this NVIS webinar session. And I guess there are some more questions that are popping up. I suggest that all the participants can contact Chaturved and also mail to us at lake2020@iisc.ac.in. We'll be taking up questions there. Thank you so much for the participation. So the mail ID will be presented on the just below this video, which will be archived on the YouTube. Thank you.